Well, let's chat now to Herman Bosman, the head of crisis incident management at TSU International. Herman, thank you for your time and a very good evening to you. What informs the increase in kidnappings that we're seeing in the country lately?
Good evening to you and the viewers. Well, this isn't anything new. I mean, we've been discussing this year in and year out, and we've seen a steady increase over the years. But as from just after COVID, we've seen the figures double every year, just about. So if we can just really briefly indicate the following, we're currently looking at one incident or just about one plus incident for every half an hour. We had 8 a day in 2010. We're now looking at the last quarter where we looked at 50 per day. And that is something that needs to sound alarms. And we need a priority committee to address this. It cannot be that we just discuss this and year in and year out, we are raising this as a severe concern.
Yeah. We'll get to how you would suggest interventions be implemented with urgency in a moment, but how do we fare with the rest of the continent as it stands? What do the kidnapping trends look like in the rest of the continent?
Well, there's various hotspots throughout Africa that we've also seen those girls taken in Nigeria, the 200 plus girls that were taken, and different, completely different type of kidnapping with completely different motive. But definitely South Africa is fast becoming the place where kidnappings are taking the lead. And there's various reasons, obviously, for that. But we should not go into a phase where we say, well, this is the new normal. And we just, you know, sort of accept it. We are very quickly at a place where we would be labeled as the kidnapping country. And we cannot afford that. We want investors and we want our economy to grow.